96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Live off the record with Zhivargo Laing is brought to you by the Cleveland Clinic, RF Bank and Trust, and Raw Star Assurance.
Welcome, ladies, and Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Monday afternoon. I trust you had a wonderful weekend. If you want to give us a call today on the show, the numbers to do so are 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796. That's 422-4796. Or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. That's 439-3043. We are live on Cable Bahamas, channel 969. That's the way my mother listens to the show. You can catch us on BTC Flow channel 612. That's BTC Flow channel 612. So I have a question for you today. It might be provocative, it might not be, but it is a question that I have for you today, that the discussion may lead us to somewhere relevant to some observations that I am making. Are you afraid of especially ideas that are abundantly different than the ideas you have become accustomed to, comfortable with, have believed the most? Are you afraid of ideas? Again, particularly the ones that you are unaccustomed to, unfamiliar with, that may in fact challenge ideas you have believed for a long time. Are you? So I was watching a documentary over the weekend, and there is no infallible evidence of the existence of King Solomon's temple. For our believers in the Bible, you recall that the Bible teaches that Solomon built a temple in Jerusalem. And it was one of the most extraordinary descriptions of a temple, a structure, to have been built ever. You know, this was a temple with lots of gold and lots of very expensive material used to honor the God of Israel, to create a place of worship and sacrifice to the God of Israel. But really, there's no archaeological evidence, no historical evidence before, beyond what is described in the Bible, to corroborate the existence ever of the temple. But there was word got out in Israel sometime in the 80s, 90s or so, that there had been found this rock, this block that was said to be a piece of the temple that had been recovered since the temple was destroyed in fire. Because if you recall, the temple had been destroyed, was supposedly destroyed by the Babylonians and burnt to the ground. And so clearly, you know, if a structure would have been found from that time, the structure would have been charred, would have had, you know, burns and so forth. Anyway, in any event, word got out that someone had discovered this structure. Now, believe it or not, right? To have discovered this, which would have been the only existing evidence of the existence, big deal in Israel, big, huge deal in Israel. And once that word got out, the Minister of Education responsible for culture sent to their, they have an antiquities authority whose responsibility is to keep people from stealing antiquities and to be able to take control of antiquities in Israel, and told them to go and find the person and this object. And they went out to do so with many elaborative efforts, et cetera, because what happened was a person who was in supposed possession of this piece took it to the Israeli authority that authenticates such relics. And that according to them, while they couldn't say it was the actual piece, an actual piece from the temple, what they could not say, what they did say was they could not say it was a fake. So that they couldn't say it was a fake. So in other words, it was as close to authentic as they could go. And so, I mean, so that heightened the concerns about this thing. And so after much investigations, they finally tracked down the gentleman who actually was in possession of it. They found a room in which he had lots of tools and stuff for forging these kinds of things. At least that's what they said. He said, no, I don't forge things. I restore relics, antiquities. That's what I do. And so they took him to court, charged him with fraud and all these kinds of stuff. And they had all the experts come before the court. Listen to me, some of the foremost expert in the world on these kinds of things came forward. And at the end of the day, they were at a stalemate, because there were experts who definitely thought it was authentic and there were experts who didn't think it was authentic. And it was so bad that, you know, when somebody was handling the stone, they dropped it and it cracked in half. And it turned out that crack in half was one of the things that really made it challenging to say it was a fake, because the material that was on the surface of the thing from the char and all this kind of stuff had penetrated the internals of this block. So that means somebody who forged it would have had to be that good to go all through this material. Anyways, so the courts ruled that not that it was not fake, but that it could not be proven fake, and therefore the gentleman could not have been said to have committed a fraud. But the idea that this thing could exist could have changed all kinds of ways in which Israel, the Bible, historicity was considered. And the matter remains outstanding to this, whether or not that block is fake or real. After the case, the Israeli Antiquities Authority refused to give the man the block. Why? Because they couldn't say it was fake, and therefore they couldn't say it wasn't real, and so therefore they wanted to stay in possession of this thing. But it is possible, it is conceivable, that we could, in the course of our search, come up with ideas of how things really were, or how things really are, or what things really exist that challenges the way we have always thought things to have been done. Because we human beings we settle into comfort. Familiarity gives us a sense of security. We love our safe spaces. We love our familiar places because it helps us feel like we're not under threat. It helps us feel like we're on stable ground. And I understand that. And then sometimes people come up to us and they want to kind of challenge our ideas. God does not exist. Jesus isn't real. Women are not inferior to men. Democracy is not the best form of government. Jesus was just a prophet. Muhammad was just a man. And on and on and on and on. Does it bother you that somebody might come to you and challenge you with perspectives, ideas that totally are dissimilar to yours? Now, don't get me wrong, because right away I could hear some very opposing personalities who would say, oh, but when people give you different points of view, you just challenge. We're not talking about the willingness to challenge an idea, rigorously or otherwise. Challenge it if you wish. But are you scared? That's different. That's totally that I disagree with an idea, new ideas, that's my right, especially in the face of evidence. So that's not what we're talking about here. We're not talking about people's sensibilities, about having people say to them, listen, we're not talking about that today, or we don't agree with that, or that's a terrible idea and we don't want to support that idea. That's not what we're talking about today. If you want to disagree with an idea, fine. What we're talking about is you're so afraid of the idea that you don't want your children to hear it. Listen to me. You don't want your children to hear it. You don't want your family to hear it. You don't want your neighbors to hear it. You don't want anyone to hear any idea that's not your idea, because you are afraid that they might actually buy into the idea. That's what we're talking about. Fear of ideas. And this is very important to the Commonwealth of the Bahamas and our progress going forward. It's important to the world, but I'm talking about us in this country today. To be able to listen to hear, not the ideas of others. That's not, because then it becomes about the other. That's irrelevant. I'm talking about the idea, to hear an idea that is different than your idea of things. My idea of things. Not to hear it, we can hear. We can even disagree with it. But to be afraid to listen to it. Are you? Think about it honestly, though. Don't shout. Don't take a knee. Well, I would never want to admit that I'm afraid of anything, because I'm not afraid of anything. Yes, you are. You and I are dominated by fear unless we have learned to overcome it. We are dominated by fear. Why won't you start a business? Why won't you apply for that promotion? Why won't you apply for this job? Why won't you do this? Why won't you say that? Because you're scared. We're scared. We are afraid. I have had to over and repeatedly talk to myself. Anxiousness is fear. Worry is fear. All of those things are rooted in fear. What is fear? Fear is an emotional response reflecting a threat of harm, a perceived threat of harm. And it is one of the most debilitating, paralyzing things on the planet. You won't approach her, you won't approach him, even though you like him, and even though he likes you, you want to do it to be rejected. You're afraid they might say no. You're afraid they might say yes. So I'm talking about an honest search. You say, you know what? I don't want to hear anybody say that there is no God. I'm afraid to hear that. I'm afraid to hear anybody say that to my children. There is no Jesus. There was never a Jesus. There was never a Muhammad. And that Muhammad is not a prophet. I'm afraid to hear that. I don't want to hear that. I'm afraid to hear people say, you know, the Bahamas really isn't all that great a nation after all. What? Are you afraid of new ideas? Are you afraid of ideas that are not consistent, supportive of your own? So let me give you a real life example. Linda Wilson was asked, the president of the Bahamas Union of Teachers, what should happen with this idea of transgenderism in the schools? Say we need to put it on the table for discussion. What? We are a Christian nation. What? Are you afraid for your children to be a part of a discussion about LGBT? Are you? How about all the different religions? Buddhism, Hinduism, Satanism, Voodoo, Obeah. Are you afraid for them to hear about the different forms of political organization, communism, socialism, authoritarianism? Are you afraid of that? How about all the different issues related and the surrounding sex? Are you afraid for them to be told about all of the different realities of sexual practices in our world? Or we should leave that alone and leave them ignorant and in the dark about it. What do you think? Well, I get silence in the room today. We're going to take a break. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break. Not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. Buy your local paper at Freeport Convenience Stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Want to reach your Grand Bahama customers? Then call Barefoot Marketing at 827-4578 or message them for ad rates via their Facebook page. Advertising opportunities now include classified ads too. Keep up with all the latest Grand Bahama News in the Nassau Guardian newspaper every Tuesday.
Vaccines we love the most, our children and our grandchildren. I vaccinated my children to protect them. Getting your child immunized can protect them against diseases like polio, measles, whooping cough, and others. So protect your child today by getting them immunized. My grandchildren are vaccinated. You should do the same. Vaccinate your children and your grandchildren and make sure they are safe.
Take advantage of the National Vaccination Catch-Up Campaign, March 25th to April 6th. Visit your nearest clinic weekdays between 8 a.m. and 7 p.m. On Saturday, March 25th, visit us at the Red Cross, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And on Saturday, April 1st, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., you'll be at the Mall at Marathon. COVID-19 vaccines are also available at all locations. This message is brought to you by Parkwood WHO, the Ministry of Health and Wellness, and USAID. I'm not afraid, to take a stand, Everybody, come take a walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I'm so glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful. The numbers are 323-6232, or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. All right, so I have a text here, says, Mr. Laing, how well can you handle ideas that conflict with your beliefs? What in the Bible, person, place, or thing is the dates in it? No dates of when the character were born or when they died. An encyclopedia has such dates because it is an actual history reference source. That is the truth, but you might blow it off because it clashes with your belief. Yes, somebody might do that. Somebody might do that. I wouldn't do that. So let me explain to you. In 1988, I was probably my most conservative Christian self. I was in the university at the time. I was at the University of Western Ontario at the time. I did not attend parties. I did not listen to secular music. I did not. I really repudiated smoking and any form of drinking. So I was probably my most conservative self. Really, as a young, in quote, believer, just wanting just to evangelize and proselytize everyone I could. This was my reality in university. But in university in 1988, I signed up for a course called The Great Philosophers. And it was my view, my thought was that I would study all of the Plato, Aristotle, Socrates, Euripides, Aristophanes, and all of these kinds of people. But as it turned out, that was not the case. I actually, what the course did was to study one great philosopher a year. In that year, the great philosopher was Gautama Buddha. Yes, the founder of Buddhism. And so rather than drop the course, this Christian conservative young man, I took the course. I got a 94% in the course. I wasn't offended that it was sharing things that in some ways aligned with and some ways are disaligned with what I had. I just did, there was meditation opportunities. I just didn't do that. But no, in university, I spent almost a year living with someone, a group of people, but someone in the group who I knew to have been a homosexual. I was my most conservative self. And I never treated that person any differently. And so forth, right? So spent time with people who were homosexual in their persuasion. And no difficulty. Discussions sometimes that conflicted with what I believe, but no issue there. And that's been my life over time. I have studied the Satanic Handbook in terms of understanding what is in it and what it speaks about. I've studied Hinduism. I've studied Islam. I've studied Taoism and all that kinds of stuff. So no, I am not afraid. I am not afraid of these ideas. Now, to your point that the Bible is a book without dates and therefore not a history book, I have to tell you, you have to amend your understanding of how history can be told. For you to say that, it would be like me writing an essay that says, I was born. I lived in Nassau. I went to Lewis Yard Primary School. I graduated Hawksville High School. I graduated the College of the Bahamas. I graduated the University of Western Ontario. I graduated Bangor University with a master's degree. And tell you all that I have given you no dates. I've given you no evidence of that. But that is all history. That is all a fact. Right? So I'm sorry. The inclusion of dates does not a history account make. Now, you could argue that that if someone wanted to disbelieve what I said, that they could disbelieve it because I would have provided no evidence. You could say that. That's true. So, and but you're wrong to suggest that the Bible has no no evidence to support its historicity. You are dead wrong on that score. The archaeological finds that reflect so many things in the Bible are astounding. So I'm sorry, you're dead wrong on that. They could take you to Israel right now in Jerusalem, and they can point you to all kinds of things, that archaeological finds that reflect accounts written in the Bible. So help yourself a little bit with that. And you're right to suggest that there are things in the Bible before which there is no evidence at the moment, you know, whether that's Noah's Ark or some of these kinds of things. But you can't say everything in the Bible is that true that way, because I will guarantee you this much. There is no one on planet Earth today who can, with authority, contradict or say that the Bible does not have some historical accuracies in it. There's no one. I don't know of any authority who would say such a thing. Not a learned person. Certainly not a historian. Now, does that mean people don't believe? Of course. Of course. Of course. So I am not challenged by when you share with me an idea that I disagree with, and I can do so passionately and forcefully, but I have no difficulty hearing the idea. You could talk to me about any idea you have, any idea. I'm not telling you how I'm going to respond or react to it, but I will hear it. I can hear any idea, and I'm not afraid of your idea. This text says, did not the Babylonian people keep excellent records? They recorded the sack of the temple and some of the items that were taken during the conquest. Does that not count as evidence that the temple existed? No. Let me say this. I'm telling you what was on the documentary that I watched, where in the documentary it's saying there's no evidence, okay? And so I don't know about whether the Babylonians carried some accounts that would have been the proof. You do know, though, that the Jewish people might hold in suspicion about their own history. So I don't know, but I don't know that to be true. This text is evidence, Mr. Laing, not personal experience. You didn't use your personal experience to question the evidence of the great temple. Evidence, proof, Mr. Laing. Evidence. You didn't use your personal experience to question the evidence. I don't understand what the context is for that at all. Honestly, I don't understand that. So maybe you'll have to help me appreciate what you're saying, because I don't understand. Right? Again, though, I am not trying to have a religious argument with you. Just to be sure, I only use it as an example. I'm saying, are you afraid of ideas? Someone comes to you, you've been an avid FNM, avid PLP, and someone comes to you and says to you, listen, man, the FNM, the PLP, are not good parties for which you should... are you afraid to hear them out? If you're the PLP, are you afraid to hear the FNM out? If you're an FNM, are you afraid to hear the PLP out? If you're FNM and PLP, are you afraid to hear the DNA, the CRI, or somebody else out? Are you afraid to hear them out? Not, do you disagree with them? That's not a problem. Are you afraid to hear them out? Somebody comes to you and says, I believe in LGBTism. I believe in same-sex marriage. I believe in this. I believe in that. Are you willing to have the discussion? Or are you afraid? If someone says, we think this should be taught in school, that should be taught in school, but that is something that is contrary to what you have always believed. Here are these ideas. That's what I'm... this is so... doing the show and other occasions that I have had to be able to do is exactly what is happening now. Where when you try to is we get into ourselves, we get into our biases, we feel the threat. let's just look at national view point of view for the moment. Can I just get on board with what? Just see, okay, if somebody came to me and who believes that let me also create this other subtlety, which is this. Already know an idea. And you already are so opposed to that you are unwilling. That is not fair. I'm not on board with that. No need to waste time. That's to tame the idea, because the minute you hear boop, 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 you shoot, you're gone. Given it a chance to a full hearing, repeating the same thing over and repeatedly to you, because sometimes people call the show right and they didn't make their point, but they need to all the distance, and you don't already understand what they're saying. You to take up all the time to hear that the minute there is a sense that the idea is objectionable to some base of fun, you don't even know, fully heard. No. That's what I'm saying. And ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo. We'll be back after this break. To take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm. Let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today, pool, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
Wait, why you look so mashed up, like clothes at the washer?
No, wait, just a hard day, wait.
Hard day? What happened? The breakfast lady ran out of tuna and gritsy.
We need to start joking about everything, you know. This serious, boy. This real serious, boy.
Wait, what's serious? Tell me.
All right, well, today, boss gave us boy one big, big contract. And nobody else get a chance and nobody say nothing.
Boy, you know that ain't right. You know government contracts ain't supposed to go that way.
Yeah, but nobody's saying nothing. Boss man just tell people to sign the papers. Then he sent me to meet his boy downtown and collect this envelope.
You need to tell somebody. You need to become a whistleblower.
You know he's a real man, but I never blow no whistle. I be drunk all my life in Junkano.
No way. A whistleblower is someone who tells people what they see when they see something wrong happening at work.
But I ain't no whistleblower, and I ain't no snitch. I still wait there, you know.
Boy, ain't nobody gonna know it's you. All you gotta do is call Crime Stoppers, or you could text them from inside the Crack Crime Bahamas app. They don't ask about you, and your call goes straight through to Miami, so nobody know you is. And if you text, your message get mixed up like Kong Salad.
Call 308-8477 from Nassau, or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands.
I'm not afraid. Take a stand, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm. Let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Ladies and gentlemen, glad you could join us here today. 6.9 FM on this. So, call, please feel free to do so on any of the following numbers. 325 4 world truth. You can text us on 42247.
Way. So starting today, I'm breaking out of this cage. I'm standing up, I'm
Why you look so mashed up, like clothes at the washer?
No, boy, just a hard day, boy.
Hard day? What happened? The breakfast lady ran out of tuna and gritsy.
We need to start joking with everything, you know. This serious, boy. This real serious, boy.
But what's serious? Tell me.
All right, well, today, boss gave us boy one big, big contract. And nobody else get a chance and nobody say nothing.
Boy, you know that ain't right. You know government contracts ain't supposed to go that way.
Yeah, but nobody say nothing. Boss man just tell people to sign the papers. Then he send me to meet his boy downtown and collect this envelope.
You need to tell somebody. You need the book.
Whistle I be drunk all my life in Junkano.
No way. A whistleblower is someone who tells people what they see when they see something wrong happening at work.
But I ain't no whistleblower and I ain't no snitch. I still wait there, you know.
Boy, ain't nobody gonna know it's you. All you gotta do is call Crime Stoppers or you could text them from inside the crack crime Bahamas about you. And your call goes straight through to Miami. So nobody know you is. And if you text, your message get mixed up like Kong Salad.
Call 328-8477 from Nassau or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today. Workout, breakfast, drop kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Monday afternoon. Producer, somebody told me I was dipping earlier. Am I still dipping or are we clear? Good. maybe this is a new idea. People don't want to hear. If you want to give us a call, please feel free to do so on any of the following numbers, 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3804. Sometime last year on this show, I said that I think the issue of same-sex marriages or something was bandying about. And I said on the show that whether we want to face it or not, that the Bahamas was going to have to come, was going to have to confront this and many other issues. Many other issues, many very difficult issues, difficult only to the extent that they may represent ideas that are uncomfortable for many because they are not traditional ideas. They are not deemed consistent with the Judeo-Christian faith, and they would appear to want to challenge the very fabric of Bahamian culture. And I still believe that to be true. And I believe how we get through these very difficult discussions will very much depend on the attitude and spirit we bring to those discussions. If we take a certain attitude, they can lead to the kind of situations that generate conflicts that can really produce violence. emotional and physical violence. Whereas on the other hand, if we do it a different way, we can have the dialogue and still support whatever points of view we want to, and at the end of the day, in a democracy, the prevailing views will prevail. But it all depends on how we see it, how we approach it, right? This text says, you're right, anytime you knowledgeable and comfortable in what you believe, no one can change your thoughts. People get scared learning other stuff when they ain't sure. Mm-hmm. Okay. There's a quote that says, you know, an open mind is like an open fist that you only close it when you have something in it. Right? This text says, would you agree that to believe is not to have proof? Then Christians have no proof because they are a body of believers. You can't claim proof if you believe. You can't claim to know if you are a believer. In Israel, they will say, this is where it is. This is where it you believed to be the place. They don't claim certainty. Belief is not a result of knowing truth. Context of personal experience was you talking about your college life in response to my first text. Well, you just didn't understand the point. I'm sorry. You said to me, you asked me the question, if I could deal with somebody challenging my belief. And I said, well, wouldn't Buddhism challenge my belief? Wouldn't Hinduism do it? Wouldn't Satanism do it? You cannot get a Christian to sit around and say, oh yeah, man, Hinduism is great. Buddhism is fine. Wonderful to believe. You wouldn't. That was my point. I wasn't afraid to sit in that class for almost 3 months and read and study this religion. That was my point. You can't see that? No? Okay. So, belief, you say belief, yes, you believe something. I don't want to get theological about it. I really don't. That's not the point today. I don't want to get theological. This is the question. This isn't about what you believe in. This is about whether you're prepared to take on board or to listen to ideas that are different than yours. That's what I'm talking about. We're not getting into the discussion about whether we believe them. You know what? You have to ask yourself the question, why? All the things I talked about, why are you harping on the Bible? Is Greek mythology real? Do you believe Hinduism is real? If you believe Satanism is real, why are you not talking to me about those things? Why the Bible? The Bible seems to have this visceral effect. Christianity, this visceral effect. Maybe it's because it's so dominant in it. Maybe because it does something to our psyche that, like, I think it, like, we get a feeling that it kind of, if we can just break free of it, we might actually be free. But you're not talking to me about it. You're not talking to me about socialism. I didn't mention that. Communism, I didn't mention that. I mentioned FNF and PLFPism. You are stuck on Christianity. Why? Ask yourself the question, why? Seriously. And this is connected to my point, which is, are you afraid to hear things that might actually be contrary to what you have so comfortably believed? Are you? You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this news break. We'll be right back.
is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Tired of paying too many bills and loan payments each month?
Shrink your monthly debt payments down to one easy payment with our debt consolidation loan.
It also has a built-in savings that pays you 5% interest.
Inquire about our debt consolidation loans today.
Call 356-7764.
Marsh the car. The lady run into me, marsh the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today, or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
When faced with an illness like cancer, we band together. We at Cleveland Clinic in Florida have your back. From advanced cancer treatments to extra safety measures at all of our locations, we're with you on this journey. For every infusion and follow-up, for every step of the way, for every care in the world, Cleveland Clinic in Florida. Get the care you need when and where you need it. To learn more or connect with a local representative, visit clevelandclinic.org/Caribbean.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today. Workout, breakfast, drop kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
I'm not afraid. Take a stand, everybody, everybody. Come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together on whatever weather, cold or warm. Let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM on this beautiful Monday afternoon. If you want to give us a call, please feel free to call us on 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-304. Three, are you afraid of ideas, particularly the ones that contradict what you believe, that may speak antagonistically to what you believe? Are you afraid of it? Not that do you disagree with it, not do you challenge it, but are you out? Give them a nice sitting. This text is, Mr. Lang, who's bringing these ideas that go against traditions? Why should we not stand against ideas we deem destructive to society? Okay, so again, the way you are framing it is that it's about you're not standing against. That's not the issue at all. And remember, I mean, I don't know how many times I have to say it, or maybe I have to say it clearly. It's okay to disagree with the idea. It's okay to stand against the idea. It's okay to protest the idea. That's not the point. But are you really standing against the idea, or are you standing against the notion of the idea being against your idea because you haven't given the idea an opportunity even to be heard? That's, I'm talking about the kind of fear that doesn't even allow or permit the idea to be heard, right? Let the idea giver, it could come from anywhere. It could come from a politician. It could come from a priest, it could come from a teacher, it could come from an international person, it could come from a researcher. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who it comes from. It can come from anywhere. The idea is, are you afraid for them? So most times if we are giving, we're going to introduce an idea, we might say, here is why there is no God, as an example. The minute some of us hear that, and I know that visceral reaction, we gone off. Oh, the Bible says only the fool is said inside there is no God, blah, 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 blah. Look, my question isn't, do you disagree with that? That's okay. My question is, can you give it a hearing? Now, let me tell you, right? I have been in the place where I couldn't hear some ideas, that's for sure. I really have, right? I really have. But there was an intolerance for even hearing the idea, even giving people an opportunity to fully vet their idea. Because my emotions would get aroused and I would like just be vehemently opposed, as opposed to just listen to what you're saying. Let me really hear what you're saying. That's, but part of the reason for me was I was afraid. I mean, I'm scared. I don't know. Ask me what I was scared of. You don't always know. But it's irrational sometimes. Sometimes irrational, just pure irrational. This is what we believe. We all believe. Blah, 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 blah. Scared of people who your parents them tell you, oh, don't trust them. You ain't even know the people. Then you get to know the people and all of a sudden it's a different story. Right? So it's not about standing against and it's not about who the idea comes from. Can you give the idea a hearing? So let me give you an example. Someone starts and say, you know what? The Bahamas should become a state in the United States of America. Man, some talking foolishness is dumb, stupid. Why would the initial reaction even be that? Why couldn't you speak on? Let me hear your views. Let me hear your thoughts on it. Well, I think the Bahamas is a micro, and I think that it is highly dependent on a single industry, and it's very highly dependent on the United States of America. And it is conceivable that in a set of circumstances and the way the world is evolving, where people are becoming more and more insular, that America might become more and more insular. And in protecting itself, it might decide to do X, Y, and Z. And therefore, in doing X, Y, and Z, it might limit or prevent significant numbers of its people to come to you, or any number of things might break out to cause that to happen. And if that then happens, you, who are reliant as you are on tourism, might not be able to survive as a micro state in an environment in which you do not have the United States of America patronizing your industry or industries the way it does today. And I think, therefore, to avoid that and prevent that, you ought to become a 51st state or 51 of the states of the United States of America. And if you did that, that means that your people would be able to flow into the United States freely and then be able to come to the Bahamas freely. You'd have access to a 400 million, 329 million people market, the richest, wealthiest country in the world. You'd be able to have so many more opportunities for you and your children and for blah, 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 blah. And you could still say, I disagree with that. I do not believe in that because X, Y, and Z, etc. So. But at least you gave it a hearing. Because you're afraid, maybe, of the notion the Bahamas is not independent. The Bahamas is not an independent country. What in the world? You're afraid that the Bahamas might not be? You're afraid? That's like California's afraid it's not an independent country. Florida's afraid it's not an independent country. You always get Florida's job. You love Florida. You love to be there and enjoy the opportunities there. Some of your family members live in there. Some live in there illegally. But you're afraid, but they are not independent states. They are part of the Confederation of the United States, the Federation of the United States. Right? But can you have that here? One day, they're going to put this question. Listen, man, I saw somebody sent a video of two men getting married in the Freeport. Two men. And people were cheering, just like any other ordinary wedding. And so somebody sent me a text to say, is this true? Is this possible? I said, well, it's possible to get married. I don't know if it's possible to be registered as married if you're seeing sex in the Bahamas. In fact, I know it's not possible, but you could go to court and try and challenge it because my understanding is there is rulings by the courts that may suggest that that is possible, right? But somebody says, I see, man, we need to answer this question once and for all. Can two people of the same sex get married in the Bahamas? We ought to be, and you go, no, sit down and listen to them, right? And so, and then when you're done, you can still say, no, I do not. not believe so. Oh, yes, I believe so. Whatever, whichever. Somebody says, no, we should get rid of capital punishment in the Bahamas. We should stop hanging. It's barbaric. It's not. No, you can sit down. What I'm talking about. I'm talking about, can we have that dialogue that is hard about hard things? So let me tell you why this is so important. Listen to our dialogue on less controversial things. Let's say in the political sphere between FNM and PLP. And listen to how caustic it can get. I'm not saying which side is more caustic or not caustic. I'm just saying listen to how caustic and personal it can get on both sides. Not just FNM and PLP. Listen to COI and PLP. Listen to the dialogue that has taken place between the minister, the chairman of the PLP and the Minister of Foreign Affairs, the Honorable Fred Mitchell, and the leader of the COI. Lincoln did. Listen to where it has gone. It wasn't about the idea, then listen to how personal it got. Now that's on the non-controversial stuff. On the non-controversial stuff, we prepared to go there. I listened to dialogue between the prime minister and the leader of the opposition, and I heard with my own ear, I heard, I got a file on you. What does that mean? What does that mean? Right? But, and this is on the non-controversial, this is on stuff that's in the bond, being debated in the bond. In an elevated environment, gotta be able to hear the ideas, not be afraid, and not to have the kind of fear. See, because let me show you something. So if you're the PLP, can you say something to the FNM that risk the FNM's ability to gain re-election to government? Presumably, that creates fear in the FNM, and that fear would lead to a reaction sometimes, maybe not the best one. And vice versa, you're the FNM, you say something about the PLP or to the PLP, you share some idea about them and the way they're approaching governance, etc. They think that that may put at risk their ability to remain in government. They get afraid. And now the fear creates a reaction that is not any longer about the policy. Now it's about you personally, or it's about something that has nothing to do with the policy. Instead of, listen, I hear you on this notion of our approach to X, Y, and Z. I want for them and people to understand why this approach is best for them. And here are the reasons why. One, boom, 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 boom. Two, boom, 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 boom. Three, boom, 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 boom. Now, let us contrast that with your idea. And let me show you why your idea is both flawed and perhaps dangerous to the country. Because A, boom, 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 boom. C, B, boom, 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 boom. C, boom, boom, boom. It's the idea. And not you at this one. I come in for you and I have nothing to do with it. But the idea. And I heard your idea. I heard it. And let me tell you why I vehemently disagree with your idea. Because you said, and this is how you know when somebody listened to your idea. You said, A, B, C, D. But here's why I find your A and your D objectionable. Because, bam, 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 bam. Not, oh, you did this, or, you know, oh, I'm coming for you, or no. Once you start getting personal, this is how I know people come to the end of their argument. When they start attacking you, their argument is dumb. They have fallen to the sword, and they are logically, rationally, and intellectually dead in the water. They now, the only thing they could do is try to bring you down, because having brought their idea down, their hope is that in bringing you down, they will take your idea with them. Well, how did that work out for the people who killed Jesus? Or Martin Luther King? How did that work out? Nah, man, you don't, you kill people, you kill ideas. This text says, I'm talking to you about it because you believe in it. And I think this person is talking about Christianity. And your opening salvo was about dealing with different ideas. You also spoke about evidence concerning the temple, so I felt my questions were timely. I felt it's wrong to claim that a belief is the only and right way. Wrong to speak belief is truth. Okay. I take your point. Okay. So you have a reason for why you have it. Your final word is to be strong. It says, I feel it is wrong. Belief is wrong to speak belief as truth. Okay. Now, why is it wrong to claim that a belief is the only right belief? Why? Why is it wrong? Since it's only the belief. Tell me why. So I believe my child. So a woman has a daughter, only daughter. And she believes she's the most beautiful person, daughter in all. That's a belief. Why is it wrong for her to believe that? Tell me, please. Why is it wrong? Not why it might be flawed, but why is it wrong? You say wrong. Is it morally wrong? Why is it wrong to believe what one some? That's not the point. The point is not that somebody shouldn't believe what they believe. The point is, are they prepared to tolerate hearing another belief? But why is it wrong to believe that your belief is the right and only way? I mean, seriously, you really, really believe that? I challenge you. Do you really believe that? You really, really believe? So you believe that if a person is convinced that you should teach a child to hate other people, and you believe that that is not so, you really believe that it's wrong for you to say that teaching children to love other people as the only way is wrong? That's what you believe. You don't believe that. You only believe that in terms of Christianity and religion, maybe. You don't really believe that. Because you teach, if you have a child, and if your mother and if your parents raised you, then you must be objecting to the way they raised you, because they believed many things as the only way and taught it to you, as did mine. Are they wrong for that? They could have been mistaken. They may have been incorrect. But are they wrong for it? As in morally wrong? Really? Seriously? Let me tell you something. In this world, we walk around all day long believing that some things are the only way. Some, and now, are we wrong for that? No. But they're flawed. Wrong? But I mean, that's what you believe. So you say, wrong to speak belief is true. Okay. It's wrong for me. Why is it wrong for me to say I believe that Jesus exists and that is the truth? Why is that wrong? Tell me why it's wrong, though. You have to have a rational argument. Tell me why it is wrong. Why is it wrong? See, you have to be careful, because the minute you say, I believe that this is that way, and you say, I feel, don't hide that. Feeling is belief. When you say that as dogmatically as you stated, you are, because why would you believe that yourself? Why would you believe that it's wrong to speak belief is true? Why? Based on what? Why are you so strong? So now I can say, I think it's wrong for you to think it's wrong for someone to speak belief as truth. No. Our beliefs may not be true, but to believe what we believe as truth, well, that's as natural as the universe. To believe what you believe as truth, that's as natural as the universe. I believe that I exist. But you know that people who can give you an argument against that? Or you could be a figment of the imagination. You could be caught up in the matrix. That's what I believe, and I speak it as truth. I speak that I exist. Why is that wrong? I'm always fascinated how you, for what they regard as your dogmatic stance, when they come at you dogmatically. So let me give you an example. People say, you are arrogant. Right? Do you realize that to state with definitiveness and dogmaticness the arrogance of somebody else is to demonstrate a dogmatism and arrogance yourself? You realize that, right? Yeah, so somebody feels very passionate about what they believe. And you come back at them and tell them passionately what you believe, and that's a problem. It's the same old adage. You point a finger, one finger, at somebody, and four points back at you. And very often it is true. We are projecting on other people what may in fact be true about ourselves. But it is coming. The Bahamas is starting to come into this explosion of confrontational ideas. And there are many things that are bringing this about. You have your children, your children go off to school and get exposed to new ideas, new people. They are all over the world by way of the internet exploring ideas. They are all over YouTube listening to all manner of people say all kinds of things. And they put them out there as their ideas. They embrace them. Mind you, don't spend that much time in really researching them or understanding it, but it connects with what they believe. Boom, all of a sudden they post it to you. They post it in the chat groups, in their chat groups, and so forth and so forth. So you have all of that happening, right? You got all this television watching and all these things that you can see these days on television. And the ideas are emerging. And our children today are not as dogmatic, as not as indoctrinated, and not as committed, and not as loyal, and not as dedicated to the ideas that we once held so firmly to, because we no longer are the kind of intense monolithic society that we used to be in terms of many kinds of beliefs. We're not. Our children are much more open. Not only are children open, the average conservative Christian today ain't close to the conservative Christian they used to be one time ago. Not even close. The level of passivity that existed in the Bahamas one time ago, ain't there no more like that. So that clash of ideas is coming as sure as night follow day. And the question is, are we ready for it when it does? How will we approach it when it does? If we can, at the moment, deal with some of the less controversial ideas in the way that demonstrates we have a willingness and not a fear to entertain the idea. So that is why belief is not allowed in the court of law. You would lose proofing Christianity in a court. You have no evidence of it. First of all, you're dead wrong. You're dead wrong. Because, first of all, the Christian isn't going to take itself to court. You would have to take the Christian to court. And if you take the Christian to court, you will have to prove that the Christian is wrong. You would have to prove it. So prove the Christian is wrong. prove that Jesus never existed. Prove that God does not exist. Prove that Paul never existed. That would be your job, not the Christian's job. He that asserts must prove. So you see, this is why I'm saying, you folks, listen, you really have to sit down and reflect. Don't react to me, sorry. Don't react to me. Don't react to whether you like my thinking, don't like my thinking, like me, don't like me. Don't worry about that. Take your own thought and examine it. But forget me and examine it. You say, that is why belief is not allowed in God. That's not true. Belief is allowed, but if you assert something, you have to prove. Right? The court don't say, don't come in here with no belief. That's nonsense. Over the courts in the United States of America says, in God we trust. Over the courts, on the money, in God we trust. Right? So don't let nobody hear you say that. Right? But if you're going to take Christianity to God, it won't be Christianity, you're going to take itself to God. You got to take Christianity to God, and then you have to prove. You have to prove whatever you say about Christianity. Not Christianity. Why did Christianity last all these years? Islam and them. People can't prove the people them wrong? Who assert? This text is, there are certain things it is okay to believe and some things not. You can believe vanilla ice cream tastes better than chocolate. That's your belief. But you don't have the right to believe what is actual and can be proven. If you heard me telling someone I believe Canada is in South America, that is something disproved, not like your belief in ice cream, which is a preference. Are you sure? Canada is in the north or the south, depending on where you're coming from. Where are you coming from? So if I'm in outer space, north of Canada, is Canada in the north or in the south? If I'm in outer space, where the South Pole, see, people, I was just having this discussion with my son. I said, space isn't one place. Space, the whole planet Earth is orbiting in space. So if you are in the south of the Earth, you are upside down being kept in place by gravitational pull. Well, if you are upside down, your head is pointing south. So anything south of your head would make your head north of that thing. See what I tell you? Reflect on what you say. Ladies and gentlemen, we're listening to Zee Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today. Workout, breakfast, drop kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
When faced with an illness like cancer, we band together. And we at Cleveland Clinic in Florida have your back. From advanced cancer treatments to extra safety measures at all of our locations, we're with you on this journey. For every infusion and follow-up, for every step of the way, for every care in the world, Cleveland Clinic in Florida. Get the care you need when and where you need it. To learn more or connect with a local representative, clinic.org/Caribbean.
The BAAA's 50th Carifta Trials are here. Get your tickets now. Trials start Saturday, March 25th to Monday, March 27th at the Thomas A. Robinson National Stadium. Come support our young athletes as they strive to be a part of Team Bahamas to represent our gold, black, and aquamarine. Join us for the pep rally and float parade scheduled Thursday, March 30th, beginning at 4 p.m. to celebrate our team. For more information, email info@charifta50.com or call 808-GOLD.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid to take a stand. Take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand. Come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm, let you know that you're not alone. Holler if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or 96.9 FM on this beautiful Monday afternoon. We were talking about ideas. Are you afraid of them? This text says, I laugh a lot. I like that Canada joke. I like that Canada punch. Well, that's the truth, actually. Not even a joke, it's the truth. This text says the burden of proof is on the believer. No. They assert, we weren't talking about what the believer is saying now. See, a believer standing outside of court could say anything. That wasn't what you said. You talked about court. Don't try to shift now. Don't try to shift the environment. All right? Outside the world, I can say anything I want. In court, it's a different story. You were the one who said you can't carry belief inside the court. A believer, why would a believer end up in court? You could only end up, the believer could only end up in court to go contest their belief if you put them there. So don't try to shift on me. Okay. Let me tell you something, why this is so important for me. Does anyone believe that the Bahamas is in the best place it could be in? Any one of you believe that economically speaking, educationally speaking, socially speaking, culturally speaking, politically speaking, governance-wise, that the Bahamas is in the best place it could be. Even if you believe it's, listen, we are as close to utopia as we could get, or you believe that we are mostly in the best situation that we could be in, there's no really any more significant place for us to be. Does any one of you believe that would be true? The number, the call is 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259 or text me at 422-4796 or WhatsApp me on 439-3043. Do you believe that there is progress for the Bahamas to make? Do you believe that there is little progress for it to make? Do you believe that there's moderate progress for it to make? Do you believe that there's lots of progress it needs to make? What do you believe to be true about this country? Are family islands where they ought to be? Is New Providence where it ought to be? Is Grand Bahama where it ought to be? As a people, are we where we ought to be? Are our children where they ought to be? Governing the way it ought to be? Is our schooling the way it ought to be? Is our families the way it ought to be? Is our church, religious, spiritual environment the way it ought to be? Do you believe that we are where we ought to be and there's nowhere else for us to go? If you do not believe that, and if you believe that there are other places for us to be in a positive way, then you have to believe, or it is likely you believe, that we will need new ideas to get there. We'll need better ideas to get there. We'll have to find better ways, better policies, better structures, better procedures, better protocols to be able to get us there. Well, the existing ideas or the ideas that existed have us where we are now. Does anybody disagree with that? Wherever they came from, whether they came from parents or they came from guardians or they came from schools or teachers or educators or they came from spiritual leaders or teachers or they came from civil society or they came from business people, whatever ideas existed or exist today, whether they came from foreigners or from Bahamians, whatever ideas existed or an existed day that we pursued or are pursuing has have us where we are today. So to be in a different place in a different way, the ideas we had or have may not be able to get us there unless we think that the way those ideas have been executed may have been the problem. And that too will require a new idea of an execution. So it all boils down to ideas. You're sitting there listening to me, and your family is in a state that displeases you. The circumstances, financial, relational, physical, educational, displeases you because you want better, you need better. Well, for the most part, the ideas that you have had and have and got and pursued and unwell, they have you where you are. What is the way out? What is the way up? What is the way forward? Has to be better ideas. We have a call on the line. Go ahead, caller, we're listening to you.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, how you doing?
Doing very good, and yourself, sir?
I'm not bad, thank you.
Good. So you mentioned ideas. I just turned on the radio and saw that I'm not sure exactly what the main subject is, but as far as
let me give you just quickly so you could have a little context. I was asking people, are they afraid of ideas, particularly ideas that contradict, oppose, antagonize against what they believe currently?
Well, we shouldn't be open. I mean, we shouldn't be closed-minded. Sorry.
Right.
To ideas, because we are thinking beings, and that's the problem with humanity, is that we have been led astray as far as the education. So this whole thing about ideas is real. This is the problem of humanity right now: is our ideas and how we are operating off of these ideas. So now, as far as resolutions are concerned, in order for a resolution to take place, everyone must acknowledge the truth. You cannot move forward and expect for a resolution for anything if you don't acknowledge the facts. If you want to say that, okay, we're going to solve this problem, without acknowledging and being honest and acknowledge the facts of what the problem is, and you're just going to dilly-dally around it and talk about, well, let's do this and let's do that, then you're never going to get a resolution. You just continue to say, okay, we'll meet tomorrow because the time's up today. I got to go home. I got to pick up the kids. This one has to do that. The next one has to do this.
Is it possible that we have to acknowledge that we don't know the truth or what the facts are? Is that true too?
I understand your point, so I don't want to appear as though I'm arguing with you. I understand.
Not arguing. I'm just, because I'm agreeing with you. I agree with you 100%, acknowledging the truth. But sometimes in that acknowledgement is, we don't know the way. We don't know the answer. So now we got to keep searching.
Right. So that comes to the point that reminds me of someone who says, the blind leading the blind, because we don't know the truth. We're dependent upon the ideologies and the principles of someone who is ahead of us, and we meet problems in place. But these people were already here 50 or 40 years before us, but we trust them because of their seniority to us. And so we meet these problems in place, and now we're here, and they look at us and say, well, you're young and you don't know. But then they die and they leave us with these problems, and now what? Because they told us we were too young to know, but they're dead and gone, and the problem is still here.
Let me give you a real example. I mean, seriously, I have faced situations in my study. I'm the father, I'm the husband, and I have children. And the truth is, they didn't know what to do, and I didn't know what to do.
Right.
And so what we had to do was we had to search for an answer, or go find people who might know. But I'm saying it's possible not to know what the facts are, not to know what the truth is.
Okay, well, let me go another angle, because this is something that people are not addressing right now. The world is being led astray by governments, by the churches, by education, period, by knowledge being corrupted and misconstrued to everyone. Everyone is being brainwashed as to how to live life. The subject matter of our existence is just to live life. There's a greater force that we don't know would put us here, but we are here. I'm having this conversation with you, okay? So this is real. So now the fact of the matter is, since we are all here, right, what's the purpose? Is it to wake up every day and go to McDonald's and serve people hamburgers and fries? Is it to go and sit inside of a building and say, oh, I'm dealing with national insurance? What is our purpose for living on Earth? And this is what governments around the world have misconstrued humanity into living lives that are pointless and meaningless now. And this is why resolutions cannot be resolved.
Let me ask you a question. You posed a question. What is the point of life? What is it? If it's not to get up in the morning and go to McDonald's and work or go to NIV, what is the, do you know? So that we can, if you are the guy.
The fact of life is facing us in our face every day, every moment, even as I'm speaking to you.
Yeah, please give it to me.
I'm giving you the answer right now. The system is designed so that you do not acknowledge that. Life
no,
is
sir.
Free.
No. But let me tell you, this is Z-Line on this show. Okay. So we've already captured your description of the problem, which is what is happening. I'm asking you. You said the governments are misleading, misdirecting people about what the point of life is. I'm asking you, what is the point of life?
To enjoy this, and we have a relationship with that, which made us.
Okay.
So all of that, the knowledge of how to be in communications with God, as humanity knows him, is lost.
Okay.
The relationship with God is lost. This is in Psalm 2.
Okay.
This is in Psalm 2.
You don't get no arguments out of me, bro.
Okay. So the communication, the relationship with the Creator and the spiritual family that is observing us right this very moment. And this is why I have the courage to speak, because I'm aware of God and I'm in communion with God constantly. Okay. And so right now, governments worldwide, no matter how much they may appear to be an enemy of each other, they are all friends of each other. Because at the end of the day, humanity is not at peace and humanity is not happy. And there's no plausible excuse as to why there cannot be peace on Earth. We make bombs. Bombs do not grow out of the ground. We make guns. Guns do not grow out of the ground. What the Father of existence has made is what we have naturally. And this is what humanity is being robbed of. We're being robbed of enjoying what the Father has provided for everyone for free. For free. This is the problem. We create taxes, which is an illusion.
In our imaginations, we have said about the things that are befalling us.
Exactly, but we're making it real. We have made our imagination real.
Yeah.
The fact of life is right in front of us. We can touch the... But we have made ideologies our problem and say, oh, I got to do this, I got to do that. But we made all this stuff up. Show me this when you wake up. Show me this for real in nature, which is the thing that you need to do.
My friend, I ain't asking other people to believe what you believe, but I certainly understand where you're coming from, and I certainly embrace that as well. You're here to enjoy yourself and connect with the reason why you could enjoy it.
Life is free. Life is free, and we are being robbed of the ability. We only have a temporary moment on this planet, okay? They place taxes and all these payments from what? We can scribble numbers in the sand. The central bank has set a sand dollar, which is an insult to all of our intelligence, okay? Do you know how many individual grains of sand, if you used to take a sand dollar on a beach and you used to shake the sand, do you know how many grains of sand come out of a sand dollar?
I
an innumerable,
I
an innumerable and an immeasurable amount, okay?
Yeah.
So therefore, this whole thing about taxes, deficits and debt and our economy being down and revenue being up, it's all fictitious.
No, they're not fictitious, man. They're real, but they are the consequences of our own pursuits. They're real. We imagined a world where we needed this.
Yeah, death was real as the Terminator, okay?
Thank you very much, man. I appreciate your calling. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, man.
Take care. This text says, facts and truth are not one and the same. Facts can support a truth. Facts can change or be argued. Truth is absolute. Facts can lead to the truth. Truth then is conclusion. Okay. So we often use the two interchangeably, but some can have their own facts perspective, however, not their own truth, as truth exists without them. I do not believe that, actually. I do not believe you can have your own facts. I do not believe that. I do not believe that you can have your own fact that says the economy of the Bahamas grew by 6% in 19 something, or and I'm saying that this is what the Department of Statistics said, and you could believe that it grew by 10%, and that's your fact. No, I'm sorry. Facts are independent of the observer, right? So no, I don't believe that. Now, you can argue that somebody got the facts mixed up, but I don't believe that. Now, this notion of whether fact is true, well, every fact is a truth, right? And now, whether every truth is a fact, whether I believe it, and that's true, that's another set of arguments, but I don't believe that you're entitled to your own facts. I don't believe that at all. This text said, say wrong person, Laing. I was in the one who bought up court, so you can read my full text now. Okay. The burden of proof is on the believer. There are certain things that exist outside of the natural laws that govern our planet and outer surrounding. Gravity is a theory that one can find and demonstrate some type of existence, but believers only have a book written and rewritten and reinterpreted as proof. Yeah, okay, so yeah, the believer outside. Well, the believer outside says what they believe. And if you don't believe them, and if you demand evidence, then if they can't give it to you, you carry on believing what you believe. That's up to you. That's not a big deal. And gravity is a theory. Remember, a theory, not a truth. It's not a truth, it's a theory. Okay? And a theory which what is that actually? What is gravity? Really, what is it? Right? What exactly is gravity? Can you prove what gravity really is? Demonstrate an effect to believe gravity is creating, but you can't prove you know what gravity is. That's why science always deals with theories. It's an explanation for a phenomena, an observed event. And theory is the explanation for that. So the theory of an observance that if you throw something in the air, it comes back down. The theory is called gravity. It's an explanation for the phenomena. But what is gravity exactly? Can you prove it? Prove what it is. These arguments can be endless. So the believer, you like the Christian believer, are no different. Prove to me that your mom and your daddy are who they say they were. You say, oh, well, I can go get my birth certificate. Your birth certificate could have been forged as others have been. There are people who have no birth certificate. Prove to me that your mom and your dad, they love you. You only know them as the people who raised you. But you believe that. You believe that strongly. You tell people, that's my mom and my daddy. You say it with conviction, without doubt. Don't come down on the Christian believer, because why? Because the Christian believer, when they believe what they believe, we got to call on the line. Go ahead, call over, listen to you.
Yes, good afternoon, Mr. Laing. I hope you're doing well, sir.
I'm okay, man. And yourself?
I'm good. You know, I just tried to call because after that previous caller I'd call. I share some of his sentiments, but I don't agree with him totally. You know, Jesus said, I have come that you may have life and you may have it more abundantly. Mm-hmm. Life, Mr. Laing, is about our choices. He said, I said before you blessing, I said before you cursing, curses. You choose. You can choose to enjoy this life, or you can choose to allow do whatever it wants to you.
But why do you disagree with him? Because his fundamental thing was the reason for life. The reason for it was for enjoyment. But you don't think that God created us to enjoy
it? No, I said I agree with that. But he's saying that to the government and all of these things that are perpetrated by whatever, you know. We are living in a world, in a fallen world, so you would always have opposition and government doing, but you have to make a choice every day to decide how you are going to live your life, irregardless of how whatever choices that the government will do.
Yeah.
Caesar will
yeah.
always run his government. Jesus did not come to intervene with Caesar. You know, he said, but this is a new way that I am going to show you how you can enjoy your life. So at the end of the day, no one is responsible for your happiness. Your wife isn't responsible for making you happy. The government isn't responsible for making you happy. It's you and your creator. Like I agree with the fact that once you are in harmony with him, he said, I will give you peace. I will give you all of these things that you need. And so it's not about everyone around you.
I agree with him on the premise of what life is about. I wasn't quite taking on all of the discussion about the government, even though, it's because...
I mean, I agree, that is the ultimate goal. Once you are, like you say, in harmony with God, living in peace with God and man. Jesus said there are only two commandments, love God with all your heart and mind, and then love your neighbor as yourself. That's all you need to do in life, and you would have, and this world would be a better place to live.
Thank you, my friend, always for calling. We appreciate it. This person says DNA can prove parents with facts. You know, let me tell you something. you all have to know, right? First of all, DNA can give you a high probability as to who your parents are, but a DNA cannot prove beyond any probable doubt that your parents are your parents. So don't let nobody fool you with that. DNA is not 100% guaranteed to prove anything. It can very, very closely say so, but it does not guarantee that that is so. So don't let nobody say it. Text says, I didn't send the proof on the believer's text, but there are things that are subjective versus objective. Subjective is open to personal belief. Objective is not. Okay. Well, an objective, something could be open to personal belief, too. It's just that it might be you're doing so unreasonably so. Say, facts are through the observation of the person's perspective. That's not true. That's not true. In fact, you're talking about information. Well, in fact, because if I observe a person walking, then the walking, that person walking is a fact, right? That person walking is a fact. That's my observation, but that's not personal, right? There are many things that exist in nature that's not personal. Our interpretations and our mental constructions and them, they personal, but the observation about a coconut tree that I observe, that my neighbor observe, et cetera, sitting in my yard, when the neighbor come to me and say, can I have a coconut off your coconut tree? That ain't personal. Me and them pointing at the same coconut tree. Maybe our perspectives on angles on the tree is different, but people call them the coconut tree. Wonder why that is. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, so glad that you could join us today for an interesting, fun kind of discussion. I trust you will join us again tomorrow. Have a great evening. God bless you. Be listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing.
Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.